Evening, and thank you for joining me for the 2021 State of the Village Address. I'm Mayor Chris Pisak, and I'm happy to join you for this look back on 2020 and to look forward to the plans and hopes that we have for 2021. It would be an understatement to say that this year was out of keeping with what was expected. The COVID-19 pandemic brought about changes to our daily life that would have seemed far-fetched not even a year ago. My thoughts and prayers go out to those that have suffered incredible losses through our journey through this pandemic. We have come to each other's side, and together we will make it to better days ahead. Sorry about that. Despite the new and challenging hurdles that we've all faced, and those ahead as we reassemble our society, some good has come about this year. I hope to highlight to you and perhaps find a silver lining to a truly unusual year. The village promptly acted to respond to the projected impacts of the pandemic by quickly adjusting its budget for this year. In a matter of a month, the budget was reduced by $4.2 million and realigned with the evolving needs of the community. These reductions, conservative budgeting practices, higher than expected revenue performance, and CARES Act funding have allowed the village to operate within its budget and focus its attention on supporting the needs of the community. Village staff were all hands on deck as cases of COVID came to the coasts, then to the Midwest. This included monitoring daily press conferences by the governor, my participation in weekly calls with the DuPage County Health Department, and reaching out through the village's partnerships and memberships in groups such as the DuPage Mayors and Managers Conference, Illinois Municipal League, and others. Staff responded promptly, focusing on protecting the health of the public and safeguarding the health of village employees. New online services were introduced for the first time in village history. For the first time in village history, individuals could apply, pay for, and receive a building permit online with the ability to request building permit inspections as well. We provided the opportunity for people to purchase their garbage stickers online and forgave the fees associated with making utility payments late. The village also extended payment deadlines when the initial stay-at-home orders were issued, made arrangements for public meetings to be accommodated through video conferencing, and waived the 2020 annual business registration renewal fees. We are appreciative for the support provided by our federal and county governments that recognize the need of local communities and provided financial support, including federal CARES Act funding, to help us through a period of tremendous increases in demands of emergency services. The village was fortunate to receive $1.2 million in federal CARES Act funding to help offset our costs for public safety personnel. We sought to carry on community traditions in a manner that protected everyone's safety. This included health safety protocols that allowed the French Market along the Prairie Walk Pond to continue to offer much needed outdoor commerce during a summer that had limited options for experiences. We found a way to keep up the traditions of observing Memorial Day, celebrating Independence Day, and the winter holidays with a caravan of vehicles that made their way through the village, sharing cheer and excitement to those gathered along the route. The village recognized early on that supporting our community meant supporting Lisle businesses. Working hand in hand with business leaders and the newly formed Lisle Economic Development Partnership, the village got to work on developing and launching an outdoor dining program. This program allowed restaurants to use village right-of-way to accommodate patrons outdoors in a manner that protected their health while allowing businesses to remain open. Temporary accommodations were made to allow outdoor dining on private restaurant property while waiving permit and inspection costs for outdoor tents. Packaged liquor was allowed to be delivered with food orders to help restaurant businesses. This and other efforts undertaken with partner organizations and agencies such as Choose DuPage, the Illinois Department of Commerce and Economic Opportunity, and others were undertaken to help businesses weather the hardships they were presented with. Another village support program, the Lisle Business Relief Program, was instituted to offset the cost of PPE for businesses and to support them through the availability of a bonus value gift card program. The first component of the program was a PPE distribution program, which allowed businesses to apply to receive face masks and hand sanitizer to support their ongoing business needs. The second element of the relief program was a reimbursement program for reopening expenses incurred in preparing for and accommodating patrons in a safe manner. Under this program, businesses could apply to receive up to $1,000 in reimbursement for these expenses. The Lisle Loyal Gift Card Program was also established, which provided extra value to those purchasing gift cards for Lisle businesses. The gift card's added value increased with the value of the card that was purchased. A more recent iteration of the village's support for businesses includes a reimbursement program for those with liquor licenses for on-premise liquor consumption. As these businesses are affected by the inability to have customers consume on the premise of the business, the village has extended this program to offset the costs of their 2021 liquor licenses. All told, the village has distributed $34,772.34 in funds associated with these programs in addition to forgiving fees. Throughout the pandemic, the village took great steps towards making sure that the Lisle business community was informed about the various programs aimed at providing support. A webpage was created to catalog the federal, state, and local programs offering assistance. Several messages went out using the balance of village communication resources, announcing programs such as the PPP, the BIG, and DuPage County stimulus, Takeout Tuesday, and other related programs. Despite the disruption and tragedy presented by the pandemic, there were also some positive developments in 2020. This includes Lisle welcoming back Westside Tractor to the village after almost 60 years since the business first opened in Lisle. Westside's acquisition of the 11-acre parcel and construction of the 83,000 square foot facility represents an investment of over $15 million. The result is an impressive facility located at 3300 Ogden Avenue, which is estimated to conduct over $13 million in sales annually. Tesla also joined the Lisle community, having completed their elegant renovation of the former Hummer dealership a few months ago. The build-out of their dealership included some nicely performed interior and exterior renovations. In total, upwards of $300,000 has been invested in this commercial remodel project. Thrive Personalized Medical Rehabilitation opened its doors at 2850 Ogden Avenue and offers short-term rehabilitation services focused on having patients recover sooner. The Westwood, located at 2441 and 2443 Warrenville Road, completed renovations, making the 300,000 square foot building extremely inviting to new tenants with an expanded cafe, fitness center, conference center, and tenant lounge and lobby. In total, $2,297,100 was invested in the building. Remprex also moved into the recently renovated Olympia Business Center at 4343 Commerce Drive, Suite 300. Specializing in the intermodal and transportation industry, we welcome their expertise and hope they find Lisle to be a great location for their business. The construction of the commercial center located at 908 Ogden Avenue was also completed, with 908 Nails opening and additional spaces available for lease. Greenleaf Foods, a leader in the plant-based food sector, leased space at 2200 Cabot Drive to accommodate its corporate offices and test kitchen. Greenleaf is dedicated to cultivating and advancing leadership in this sector and holds the brands Field Roast Grain Meat Company and Light Life Foods. E-Process, a website creator specializing in the automotive dealer category, also opened their doors at 701 Warrenville Road, Unit 300. They join American Commercial Bank and Trust, F45 South Lisle, Salon Nova, Fit Body Boot Camp Fitness Studio, Despair Logistics, Go Configure, DPG Real Estate, Scrims Esport Gaming Center, and the Wedding Design Studio and Bridal Boutique. Welcomed additions to Lisle food and drink scene include the Beer and Now Tap and Bottle Shop, Pisces Cafe, Astoria Bakery, and Sizzly Pizza. Building permits remained strong through 2020, with permit numbers comparable to the number of permits issued in 2017. With the help of the village's new processes for online processing, payment, and the scheduling of inspections, we will continue to support reinvestment and building in Lisle. Being a helpful partner to developers, contractors, building owners, and residents in their efforts to build and refurbish helps support the community through increasing the village's equalized assessed valuation. The equalized assessed valuation, or EAV, for 2019 is estimated at $1,106,413,084. This represents a 3.17% increase over the last year. The increase is attributable to new construction, which is estimated at a little over $7 million. The increasing of the village's EAV, along with the village board electing to keep the property tax levy flat for the fourth year in a row, has contributed to lessening the property tax burden for Lisle residents. Keeping the property tax levy flat, coupled with the increase in EAV, means that the village's portion of the property tax levy has decreased for 4 years in a row. Understanding financial burdens of residents, businesses, and customers, the proposed fiscal year 2021-2022 budget developed by staff will not include increases to fees or fines and will include a continuation of the Village Board's policy of flat property tax levy for the fourth year in a row, all without impact to essential village services. This year, Lisle made excellent headway in establishing the Lisle Economic Development Partnership, or LEDP. This public-private partnership is committed to proactively fostering economic growth and stability through collaboration, innovation, and providing leadership and resources that advance Lisle as a vibrant, healthy community. Executive board members have been appointed and include Heath Greenfield of Cantor Millward Brown, Cynthia Sally of Blend Facial and Style Bar, Anthony Iannone of North American Pizza and Culinary Academy, Eric Ertmote, our village manager, Trevor Ryan of the Marquette Companies, myself, and trustee Kathy Coetzel. The LEDP has already played an important role in supporting the business community through collaborating with the village in establishing the Lisle Business Relief Program. The LEDP has collaborated with the village in supporting the Shop Small Business Saturday initiative, where a pandemic-safe way of promoting and patronizing local businesses was highlighted. The LEDP has also conducted stakeholder interviews with community members and has enhanced coordination amongst the regional economic development partners, such as Choose DuPage, DuPage Convention and Visitors Bureau, and the Illinois Department of Commerce and Economic Development. In the months ahead, the organization will be unveiling a new website to complement their social media presence. The village has also made progress in addressing its strategic priorities. This year, the special events permitting application was completely reimagined, with clarification regarding regulations, the process, and required documentation at the forefront of the effort. It has resulted in relaxing pinch points and alleviated confusion regarding the process. I hope it will encourage and help build on the events that help foster our sense of community. We made progress in planning for our future by adopting long-term plans for the village water, sewer, and stormwater master plans, and the bicycle and pedestrian infrastructure. Long-term planning helps to enable proper financial planning that will sustain these systems into the future. In planning for and scheduling regular maintenance and replacement, we are ensuring that we can derive the greatest value we can from these vital systems while taking pointed efforts at avoiding costly surprises. As I've been known to say, you have to plan your work and work your plan. This past year, the water system capital needs and the fees associated with water service were all reviewed and evaluated. Conducting this review enabled the village to identify steps to be taken to avoid a situation where drastic increases to water rates are necessary to maintain the system. Through this process, the village reviewed and considered a water rate structure that would minimize the impact on customers while at the same time adequately support the system into the future. We were glad to be able to identify and approve a rate structure that accomplishes this while continuing to keep the cost of water down. In fact, Lisle's water rates are among the lowest in DuPage County. The village is also modernizing its zoning code to reflect the best practices of today. Through this process, we hope to introduce improved clarity of zoning regulations, encourage appropriate development and redevelopment, remove complexities that artificially hinder processes, eliminate provisions that are unfriendly to residents, businesses, and developers, and regulate land uses in a fair manner. The village also secured a 100% renewable energy, electric energy aggregation program where small businesses and residents can obtain electric power derived from 100% renewable sources at the same price that it would cost them to obtain a supply from ComEd. The village also worked to support the 2020 census and has focused efforts internally to continually improve its employee team in pursuit of meeting and exceeding the expectations of the public. This includes key personnel hires in the financial department, a new chief of police, and the appointment of new deputy chiefs and sergeants in the police department. The village is also continuing its efforts to embody the principles of equity, diversity, and inclusion within its employee team. A recent example of this includes a current effort of updating and modernizing the testing process for our officers and sergeants within the police department. We are fortunate to have these highly qualified and high-performing employees as part of our team. An excellent example of the caliber of our employees was demonstrated earlier this year when Officer Bill Wise saved the life of a 14-year-old child trapped in the basement of a burning home. Officer Wise undertook heroic action in locating the boy through a basement window well and pulling him to safety. The village has also undertaken a pilot vehicle leasing program with Enterprise Fleet to determine what savings could be realized through a leasing arrangement versus outright vehicle ownership. Though in its early stages, staff is monitoring for savings and possible expansion of the program. The village has continued to do an excellent job in communicating its financial position. In fact, the village continues to receive recognition for these communication efforts, having now received the Certificate of Achievement for Excellence in Financial Reporting for the 17th year in a row. The first ever Distinguished Budget Presentation Award was also received this year, and the village published its first budget and brief document, which is an executive summary of the budget, designed to make the major elements of the budget easily accessible and understandable. 2021 holds much promise, including increased COVID-19 vaccination and a path towards resuming a way of life that resembles something more familiar. I look forward to more in-person encounters and exchanges and to several initiatives that will continue to improve the quality of life for those in the village of Lisle. That includes potential redevelopment in downtown Lisle with opportunities existing on each corner of Main Street, south of Ogden Avenue, as well as the larger downtown region. The Ogden Avenue corridor is another location with much opportunity, With the recent developments of Westside Tractor and Tesla and future projects such as the Buc-ee's at 1917 Ogden Avenue and O'Reilly's Auto Parts at 1909 Ogden Avenue. This also includes the redevelopment at the former Chin's 34th Street Fishery, which is undergoing the process to prepare the site for a future food service tenant. We look forward to assisting these new businesses through the approval process and welcoming them to the village. There's also much positive activity occurring in the corporate corridor. Reinvestment in buildings along the corridor is strong as investors see the value in their buildings with strategic locations near two major expressways, access to a welcoming downtown and a metro commuter train station, and a location in a region offering excellent housing, recreation, and other amenities. Recent investments made in buildings in the corridor have made tenant spaces extremely attractive to prospective tenants. These investments, which are adding amenities that qualify spaces as Class A, are modernizing spaces to attract the new era of employees and the best of talent. The village is also investing this year as steps were taken to account for the condition of our infrastructure and plan for its maintenance and future build out. The village has adopted long-term plans for our sewer, water, stormwater, and bicycle and pedestrian systems. We are in the process of undertaking a similar process for village roadways and will be reviewing data collected on the condition of our roadways and the steps necessary to continue to maintain them in a condition that meets the needs of residents and businesses while deriving the most value from available funding. Coming this year, a $642,000 project will take place on Abbey Wood and Green Trails Drive to restore the roadway with funds from the Federal Surface Transportation Program. The village will also conduct its annual road program, which represents a $1.3 million investment in maintaining village roads. Following the adopted stormwater master plan, the village will be acting to take steps identified as necessary to improve stormwater drainage and conveyance. Accordingly, next year's proposed fiscal year budget will also include projects laid out in the adopted 10-year stormwater master plan, which includes $205,000 for engineering and construction for a project on Rolling Avenue near Lisle Junior High, $140,000 for engineering and construction for a project on Gamble Road, $50,000 for engineering phases 1 and 2 for a project on Kingston and Maple Avenue, $225,000 for engineering phases 1 and 2 for a project at Village Center in Maine, All told, the steps taken by the village have maintained the village's designation in the community rating system, which contributes to decreased flood insurance premiums by those with a need for flood insurance. The proposed capital improvement program will also include $431,000 in funding for engineering and construction of a water main to be located along Southport Avenue, $30,000 in funding for the annual valve insertion program, and $275,000 for improvements to well number 5 of the village's backup water system. Supporting our water utility also means putting into place the established and equitable water rate structure to sustain the system into the future. This will go into effect on May 1st, 2021, and begin to establish the sustainability while minimizing the financial impact on residents and businesses. There are also some exciting milestones ahead for the Lisle Economic Development Partnership. The recruitment and selection of an executive director lays ahead, along with a formalized funding agreement with the village to include a private investor component. I look forward to these important milestones for this organization and for the vitally important role it will play in assisting the business community rebound from the impacts of 2020. This past year has represented challenges and impacts to our way of life in a manner that most of us have not ever experienced. Lisle has again demonstrated its resiliency, flexibility, and ability to prevail despite the obstacles encountered. I am proud of our community's ability to weather these challenges and our efforts in coming together to assist one another in making it through to more promising days. Thank you for your time this evening. I hope you'll join me in looking ahead to a year which we learn from our experiences, become stronger, and value the things most impactful and meaningful in our lives here in the Village of Lisle. Speaking of Lisle residents and businesses, I'd like to take this opportunity to announce this year's Community Recognition Award winners. Multiple worthy nominations were submitted for people who have done wonderful volunteer work in Lisle. It is inspiring that those who rose to the top of those submissions pleaded that they not be publicly acknowledged. They prefer to work quietly to advance the community of Lisle. So on behalf of this year's citizen winners, this award is given to the hundreds, if not thousands, of those who quietly, tirelessly, and selflessly volunteer in myriad ways. Both selected nominees encourage everybody to volunteer in any way possible. From a business perspective, Midwest Auto Body of Lisle has been nominated by the Lisle Chamber of Commerce and selected for their outstanding efforts to, help the Lisle community. Midwest Auto Body of Lisle developed a program to give back to the Lisle community as well as support Lisle businesses and students. When a customer of Midwest Auto Body of Lisle spends more than $500 on auto repairs, they receive a $25 gift card to a local Lisle small business. This program supports the local businesses impacted by COVID-19 and also brings awareness to their customers of Lisle businesses. They have now invested $2,000 in gift cards to Lisle restaurants and businesses. In addition to that program, they have established the Dents and Dings for Education program, which donates all proceeds for minor repairs of $100 or less to the Lisle Education Foundation. To date, the general manager, Amish, has donated just over $2,000 to that fund. Amish Patel, general manager of Midwest Auto Body of Lisle, states, "My family has always believed that we rise by lifting others. We are proud to showcase other local small businesses during this pandemic and equally proud to support Lisle area students through the Lisle Education Foundation. We are all in this together. I wish to thank all volunteers who make Lisle a better community, and it shows. Thank you all, and God bless."